everybody. My name is June. Welcome to our channel. And you have a millionaire mind. Today, I have a guest, and she is none other than the founder of Success Resources, and her name is Veronica. Let me tell you that it's like she is the person behind Success Resources success. Today, I have a privilege in India, Chennai. I have a chance to sit down together with her for this interview. So let's ask her a few questions. But before I do that, if you like what you're doing, remember to subscribe to our channel and click on the notifications. Hi, Veron.
Hello.
How are you doing today?
Fantastic.
So,
we are in India, like you said. In a beautiful place called the Temple Bay Radisson Blue Hotel. At the back of the room are classrooms that we are hosting the 11th Making the Stage. Today is like the fourth day. It's the second last day. We are ending soon. So it's very relaxing here. I love it. And so good to connect with June again. This new day we get to rekindle like long time friends, you know, and I'm excited. Thank you.
Just to let you know that Making the Stage, we have 63 customers from 23 countries. Can you imagine that?
It's all over the world, yeah.
And this group of people, they will be the future best speaker in the world. I can't be biased because they are doing very good in the class.
This program that we identify potential speakers, and some of them want to continue their journey to grow with Success Resources, becoming a trainer for the Millionaire Mind Intensive, or even to be our trainer for other programs to speak on our stage. So we are always looking forward to this event because it's like the end of the year, and yet we see all the best of the best customer trainer gather in one place. We were doing like talent scouting, correct, June?
That's right. You know, it's like when I meet up with Veronica, then I would like to take this opportunity to let our audience know how actually Success Resources start. From my perspective, okay, it start with a love story. But I would like Veronica to share with us what actually inspired Richard and Veronica start Success Resources.
So, Success Resources started, no, not by choice. It was an accident. 25 years ago, Richard and I, we were all part of a volunteer group. Now, it's always so important to be part of a volunteer group, and that's why we're constantly encouraging all of you to come back to our event, to be crew, to be on the logistic, because when you volunteer, you serve, you will never imagine what is going to happen as long as your intention is correct and you come with the right serving heart, yeah? Richard and I were in this non-profit organization where we all run seminars for a convention. It's the first time we did the convention in Singapore. We did it so well. We had so many attendants. We had like 800 over attendants. We made more money for the club more than before. So we did it so well that someone said, Richard, why don't you look into doing this as a full-time job? Because at that time, Richard was also out of job. You remember those days where the oil prices were so high that all the oil wells were capped. And Richard was a marine engineer, and then he was out of job. So he was thinking, why not? Since I'm out of job, and yep, let's do it. At that time, Richard and I were just friends. Together with another friend there, Patrick Liu, three of us got together and say, I think we can consider to do this as a full-time job, because what we do in this business changes life, help people to understand there's more to life, more to possibility of what you can be, and that the basic academic education is not good enough to get you ready to prepare you for the real world when you're out there. So what we decided is that we like sales. You remember, Richard, myself, Patrick, we love sales. So we say that the first seminar we want to work on is sales mastery, and maybe we should read books. And we found that the best sales speaker at the time was Tom Hopkins. Remember the book, How to Master the Art of Selling?
Yeah.
Yeah. Those days, there's no email and no fax. What we do, we have to use letter writing, send him a letter by post. We didn't get an answer, but then Richard and Patrick decided they would take fly all the way to America to look for them. We found Tom Hawking and invited Tom Hawking. We sold him the idea to come, did a program for us, and that's the first event we call the National Achievers Congress, where we had Tom Hawking, Joe Girard. And that's how we got started. And from there, it was never looking back at the end.
During the time that it's like you met Richard when you volunteered for the club to organize the program, three of you is friends. Actually, Richard and you is friends. After that, is it a following years?
Yeah.
Then we organized the first National Achievers Congress with Tom Hawkins and Joe Girard. And Joe Girard is the best salesman in the world. And that is like, it's a very strong start for Success Resources with together with Tom Hawkins and Joe Girard as a team.
Absolutely. We love that because we have been brought up to understand that, you know, selling is everything. There's any skill that you want to learn and you want to master, the first thing we want to learn is to teach everybody the art of selling, because without selling, nothing happens, you know what I mean? So to us, running the first program with a sales team is what we feel is important for all our new customers to go. And then subsequently, we bring in a lot of programs in the area of attitude, you know, personal development, in the area of attitude, the can-do attitude, yes, I can, you know, you have a positive mind, with a positive mind, you can do, you know, a lot of things. So this is how we all got started in the early days with speakers like Brian Tracy, Zig Ziglar, Robert Schuller, even Oji Mandino, you remember? And that's how we are the pioneers of bringing world-class speakers from the America to be in our part of the world, Singapore and Malaysia, because we want to bring this to the doorstep of everybody in our own country.
Wow, can you remember the year?
I think it's 1992. Yeah, 1992. Almost 25 years plus. Then after that, we got to bring Robert Kiyosaki.
It's such a long journey.
It's a long, long journey.
Long, long journey.